So today it's going to be a short video just on the RME DigiFace and specifically how to connect two up to one PC. A lot of the times one RME is going to be fine because let's be honest, you've got like four channels of eight ADAT. That's quite a lot for certainly a small studio, but I tend to have quite a few synths as I've shown in other videos. So, you know, it's a bit kind of getting a bit ridiculous in here. It's a bit of a, you know, obsession. So like a lot of people are going like this now and collecting old stuff and buying new synths, and so there's plenty of opportunity to you know, get your gas up and get loads more equipment. So I thought rather than have an analog mixer, which is now on the floor over here, which is sad, I do like that mixer and I may keep it, but I've decided to go full ADAT. So rather than have that, I have now the RME front ends here. Now what I've done, this is a bit tricky to get this connected up, but what I've actually done here is plug in first of all both into USB, obviously. I use separate USB channels rather than put them into a hub or something, just for to make sure there's no kind of cross compatibility problems or anything like that, or issues with the hub. So on the first pair here, that's like ADAT1, ADAT2, ADAT3. Now this is where it gets a tad tricky. This is ADAT4 in and ADAT4 out, and this is the link between the two RMEs. So what that does is it enables me to have three spare by eight ADAT channels. Now, I'm sure there's another way of doing this, but I found it quite tricky to get this to work. I did have everything sort of in here and then it's like a link to eight and stuff like that, but it didn't seem to work too well. So after a lot of messing about, that's what I've come up with. So I just thought I'd take this opportunity to show you the RME software. So if we go in here, we've got the first part of the software, which is the basic settings. So this is for DigiFace 1, which is like my main DigiFace on the left. So buffer size, like a lot of interfaces, is just set 256. All the output format is set to ADAT. The options here, output, total mix. What that means is you'll get a total mix mixer window, which comes with the RME. And input, that's just like a timestamp thing. I don't use it. WDM devices, that's your Windows hardware. So my monitors are ADAT1 and 2, and also a speaker set up on that on the phones. So just leave that as is. Down here we have the clock mode, which is 48K. And the clock source, now this is set to input 1, which is my Focusrite 18i20, because it's got word clock. And then the input status, so that's the Focusrite locked in, that's the Octopre locked in, and that's the Behringer locked in. Nothing on 4, because it's the link to the second RME. So here's the window for the second RME. Again, everything's set the same way. It's important that the samples are set the same and everything, and that the sample rate's set the same. One thing I should mention is that total mix is ticked on, so you will get a second total mix mixer window. It's not possible to have a one overarching window for both devices because it's kind of like hardware related. And also the WDM devices, I haven't set anything up here as far as the monitors because I only need one set of monitors. Actually, I think this can interfere really with the setup, so I've just left that off. Clock source is input 1, and what that is the link then into input 1 of the second RME, and you can see that's synced. So that's good. Secondly here, we have the next part of the software, which is the total mix windows. So this is set up, first of all, for my DigiFace 1. So that's all my synths I've currently set up with my existing DigiFace and the hardware outs and stuff. All, you know, GXP, GXVP, etc, etc. Click here to get the second instance of TotalMix. This is for the new RME device. Now, I'm not using this at the minute, so it's kind of just like ADAT 1, 2, 3, etc. But it's to say it's not possible to have an overarching one, but this works pretty well.
So the ADAT front ends I have are as follows. The bottom one is the Focusrite 18i20, and it's sort of what does the clocking. So the next one up is an Octopre, and I have that clocked to the bottom Focusrite via word clock. The next one up is a cheapo, you know, Ultra Gain by Behringer. Quite a good interface, I must say, and it's used for synths, so I'm not really worried about mic quality or anything with that. And then I have another one on behind me here, which I'll not show you, but it's just the same as the Behringer. So that's the front ends, and they're all synced and locked in. So a hell of a lot of ins and outs there. Now, I know ADAT's a bit long in the tooth now, but the RME interface gives really good results in my opinion. And some people say, oh, you know, all these awful cables and fibre optic, they're so flimsy. Well, yeah, unless you've got like a mad monkey running around your studio, like ripping stuff out. I mean, you know, they're probably going to last okay. Maybe in a live band environment, yes, they are fiddly. And something like a ProSonus stage box, you know, straight to your mixer with one Cat 5 is amazing. I mean, I have to say that, that's just a brilliant solution. But this is really good for me because one, I've already got it, and two, the latency is brilliant. So I don't know what the latency would be from like an RME, or sorry, from a ProSonus, you know, into like a Clark Technic USB converter. I don't know if it's going to be as good as what I've got. Plus I have to buy a lot of new kits. So really, this I think is a really good solution. And I do like these boxes. Now they do run kind of hot here, but probably because they're sitting on top of this. So thank you very much for watching this short video. Just for those RME users who maybe want to expand their ports. So if you like this kind of thing and you like to see synths opened up and fixed, like and subscribe, and I'll see you back for another video soon.